Let's learn IIB. Today, we will create an ODBC database connection on Windows machine, then associate it with IIB, and then test the connection through IIB. Use ODBC AD32.exe file available in C, Windows, System 32, and create a system DSN. User DSN will be visible only to your account. System DSN will be visible for all users. DataDirect is the creator for ODBC drivers that IBM packages with IIB. I have installed developer version of IIB on my machine. It gives me two ODBC drivers by default, Oracle and Sybase. For other drivers, you will have to put in some more effort, download and install them. I once faced an issue with Oracle driver on IIB version 10.0.0.13. If I remember the version correctly, that is. The new driver provided with this version of FixPack had issues working with unopened cursors. So just keep in mind that when you debug your code, you will have to fix and find problems in non-SQL areas as well. The fix that we applied was to modify the version of ODBC driver without modifying the version of IIB FixPack. Let's create an Oracle DSN now. Click the Add button. Select 64-bit Oracle driver from list. Take a good look at this window. Your IIB application will suffer if you configure this incorrectly. IIB will throw exception in case of a configuration IIB is not happy with during runtime execution of some DB operation. Using that error details, you can fix your ODBC configuration later. Remember to reload the integration server afterwards. For a novice user, the other tabs such as performance, bulk, shown are not necessary at this time. When you want to increase the throughput of IIB, then you will have to revisit this configuration and modify pooling tab. When you want to encrypt the data that gets sent over wire to and from the database, then you have to visit security tab and provide a public-private certificate for encryption. Provide name for your DSN along with connection details such as host name, port, service name. Now to test your connection with credentials. We got ORA 12203 error, unable to connect to destination. ORA is an identifier for errors related to Oracle database. BIP is an identifier for errors related to IIB. When you get connection errors, let it be HTTP, DB, Q or other, use ping and telnet for initial diagnosis. You can understand if the remote server is up and running. Also, network from us to the remote machine is available using ping. When ping is successful, go for telnet. This tells you that firewall is open for this port between the two systems and set port is actively listening. Using these commands and netstat, I found Oracle service XE was down. Fixing that by starting XE service and TNS listener of Oracle. With the picture, now we know that the fix we applied is working. Connection test from Windows ODBC driver setup tool also completes successfully. Next, we have to associate this DSN to IIB. You have to provide IIB credentials to connect to the DSN. You have to provide the software IIB connections of the database to connect to DSN. We do that by using mpsi dbparams command. Use mksidbparams command to set security credentials for a specific user ID and password for connections for the resource shown on screen. You can also set user ID and SSH identity file for SFTP. Screen shows syntax of MQSI setDB params. Now, screen shows an example that you can use for DSN link up with IIB. In ACE, that is IIB 11, integration servers are independent of integration node. That is why the first example takes workspace directory with -w argument. If you recall the IIB version displayed previously, it was version 10, which means you have to use second example command shown on screen. After that, you execute MQSI CVP command to check if the password that you set is valid. MQSI CVP command is used to perform verification tests on an integration node to verify ODBC connections and perform CPU benchmarking process. Screen shows syntax. Use the second example shown on screen. The parameters that you configured on ODBC driver setup tool will be visible on MQSI CVP results. You can see what data types and functions are supported and what are not. I have used this DSN in a REST API project. Link to the YouTube video explaining that is in description. What did we learn today? We learned which tool to use to configure DSN on Windows. We learned about the different drivers that IBM provides. We learned how to enable a function or data type. Similarly, how to disable it. We touched upon performance and encryption with DSN. We tested DSN using Windows driver setup tool. We learned how to associate DSN to IIB. We learned how to test this association. If you found the video to be useful, subscribe to my channel and share your feedback in the comment section. Code is available in GitHub and some documentation is available in the blog post. Links in description. See you in the next video.